Good afternoon. Welcome to a fun night of entertainment. To open the show, may I present Audrey?
Now you can hear me, right? Okay, bear with me. There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing, everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere can you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you opened and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they've hung a star. Let's go on with the show. I like that. Opportunity, if I forget anybody, to thank them, because at the end of the show it will be chaos and I forget. So I'm thanking everybody ahead of time for all your effort. Go on with the show.
And now we are all going to a ball game with Ruth and some of her friends. And welcome to Fenway Park, home of the Boston Red Sox, World Series champions of 2004. We are now presenting Calvin and Lydia.
You're on that.
That's what
the program we got was different.
The program, is it?
Hello. It's a bit different. Let me take you back to 1993. Back in the days, can't remember them very well, before Pamela. Some of you who have kids remember that when you were just married, you could do all kinds of incredible things, like pretend you were back in college and do all-nighters. Well, one of the all-nighters that we pulled, or series of them back then, was some of you know that Lydia comes from Belgium. Some of you also know that Lydia speaks French. And some of you also know that Lydia composes music. Well, back then, She composed music for the French-speaking churches in Europe, in France and in Belgium, Luxembourg, and a number of other places. So, we're going to invite you to come back to 1993 and revisit one of Lydia's composition projects where she produced a songbook for those churches. And we're going to do a couple of songs from that time. The first one is Saint-Esprit, Holy Spirit. It invites the Holy Spirit to come and live in our lives, the Holy Spirit who sees into our hearts. The second one is probably more familiar, which is the song about the tax collector who says, Jesus, come to my house. Viens dans ma maison. This will be a little different from what we do on Sunday mornings. Okay.
Yes?
Go.
Yeah.
show the ones ever touching. To do the pray, I'm a pardoning. Oh, come here to my side. Yen dan ma mi zo, Seigneur. Yen dan ma mi zo.
Yesteryears, may we present Fred and Ginger.
Send me, darling, you infatuation, but oh, it lasted so long. Now I find myself wanting, I wanna marry you and take you home.
Day, get a song like that. Up next, we have Bill Merrill, who's going to be singing a song.
He was 1929, and a writer and a musician got together. Vincent Yeomans and Billy Rose, and they wrote a play called Great Day. Now, not many people hear much music from Great Day anymore, but one of the main pieces in the song was called Without a Song, and I'd like to kind of dedicate that song to all you people out there who know what it means to be able to sing a song.
Oh.
next piece of music won't require an introduction, and the second time I go through this thing, I want you to sing it with me.
Present Don and Jean with a skit they like to call the Life Assurance Plan.
Hey, come on in.
Hey, I was just walking by and I noticed a sign out there. Life Assurance Company?
A regular sign?
Life Insurance Company?
No. Sign is correct. Let me explain. You know, most insurance companies offer protection for those family members who are left behind when the policy holder passes on. But our policy protects the one who passes on. And our office is open all the time.
Well, that sounds good. Can you explain?
Sure. Everyone's going to spend eternity somewhere. Those who accept our conditions are assured of a special place after they pass on, where the streets are paved with gold.
How long have you been in business?
About 2,000 years or so, give or take a couple.
But this is a pretty barren office. No computers, no file cabinets. How do you get along in such little overhead?
We don't really spend a lot of money on office equipment, as you can see. We like to put our money to good work.
What are your hours of operation?
Oh, we're open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year.
Boy, that sounds too good to be true.
No, it's true.
I bet the premiums are extremely high for an insurance company like this.
Oh. Certainly not. There are no premiums.
But how does your company stay in business without any income?
Well, our CEO has no need of money. He owns a cattle on 1,000 hills. I'm sure you've heard of him since his name is mentioned many times a day.
He must be one of the stock market gurus who made millions on some gimmick like Bill Gates.
Not really. He invests in people. And there's no one like him on earth. And you'd be amazed what he creates.
I would really like to meet him. Can I meet him sometime? Can I make an appointment?
Well, you don't need an appointment. He's available 24 hours a day.
My eye candy camera.
No, no. This is all on the up and up.
Tell me where I will end up if I accept this policy. Will it be Aruba or Hawaii?
Not really. Just let me tell you about a few of the amenities. You receive a new body, which you could use.
Easy for you to say.
One that will have no pain or suffering. There'll be no more tears there, and you'll never die again. You'll never grow old, and there'll be no night or day. It'll be bright all the time. And probably the best part is that you will see other family members and friends who have accepted our conditions.
Okay, you've convinced me. Where do I sign?
There's nothing to sign.
But how do you know I've accepted the terms of the conditions?
I had men just write your name in this book once you have accepted these conditions. And you can never be rejected. Plus, there's no physical exam, which is good for you.
There's a lot of ad-libs. That wasn't in here. I bet the conditions are so hard that nobody could be accepted for this great deal.
Well, actually, it's quite simple. But they do require a lifestyle change.
I knew there was a catch to it. You don't get anything like what you explained for nothing.
Well, that's true, but let me explain what you have to do. I'm sure you've heard about Jesus. If you confess him with your mouth and believe in your heart that he is the Son of God and was raised from the dead, then you will be saved and receive all the great benefits that I explained earlier.
I do believe in Jesus. He was raised from the dead, but I have never confessed my belief to anyone. No one has ever presented this message to me before. And I do accept him as my Lord and Savior. But you said there had to be a lifestyle change. What does this mean?
Well, true faith will demonstrate itself in action. Also, true faith is not a single event, but it's a way of life. All of us are sinners, and many of the things we do each day are not part of God's plan for our lives. God sent Jesus to die for our sins and open up the pathway between us and God. Once we become part of his family by accepting him, we must try to live a life that is pleasing to him. It's not easy, but just look up there. These are your new family members who will help you learn more about Jesus by joining in fellowship with them and studying his word, the Bible. And the last thing that's required of you is that you become a witness like the rest of us and pass on his message whenever the opportunity arises. Here's your instruction manual. It's been on the bestseller list for years.
Thank you.
All right, welcome to the family of God.
That was very nice, very nice. Well, everybody gets situated in the back. Our next performance is going to be Sharon and a group of people playing instruments known as boom whackers.
They need to go.
Gotta bear with us and give us a couple more minutes to get situated. Now, little did you all know, we are actually in the South Pacific. Bet you didn't know that. Well, on an island way out here in the South Pacific, we're gonna hear from some very, very lonely sailors. No good. And then followed by some very upset nurses, which is also no good. So, whenever they're all set and situated, you'll hear from them.
We got sunlight on the sand, we got moonlight on the sea, we got mangoes and bananas you can pick right off a tree, we got volleyball and ping pong and a lot of dandy games. What ain't we got?
We ain't got dates.
We get packages from home, we get movies, we get shows, we get speeches from our skipper
and advice from Tokyo Rose,
we get letters doused with perfume,
we get dizzy from the smell.
What?
Put on a clean white suit for.
What we need is what there ain't no substitute for.
There is nothing like a day, nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name that is anything like a day.
We feel restless, we feel blue,
we feel lonely and in brief.
We feel every kind of feeling,
but the feeling of relief.
We feel hungry as the wolf felt when he met Red Riding Hood.
What don't we feel?
We don't feel good.
Lots of things in life are beautiful, but brother,
there is one particular thing that is nothing whatsoever in any way, shape, or form like any.
Santa Claus.
It's a waste of time to worry over things that they have not.
Be thankful for
the things they got.
There is nothing you can name that is anything like a day.
There are no books like a dame, and nothing looks like a dame.
There are no drinks like a dame, and nothing tastes like.
Hi.
Hi.
Yeah. So.
Knock knock.
Knock knock. Oh, that's right. It's intermission. No, it's not. I'm lying. There's nurses. Are we going to hear from nurses? There's nurses. Hey, nurses. I knew I was doing my job right. Nurses, are you ready?
They're ready. We're ready.
They are ready. Let's hear the nurses.
I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way. Get the picture? I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms. I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms. I'm gonna wave that man right out of my arms and send him on his way.
Me with good jokes that I can tell. Number one, why did the man put a... All right, no, I got it. Why did a man put a tape measure underneath his pillow? Why? What, you wanna know why? Because he wanted to see how long he could sleep for! Okay, it gets better. Where do pencils come from? Pennsylvania! Oh, it's so good. Okay, here's a good one. Here's a good one. Hey, not from the peanut gallery over there. All right, how do you put an elephant? No. Yes, how do you put a giraffe? Wait. I'm so bad at jokes, I'm not supposed to be a comedian. Okay.
Giraffe?
How do you put a giraffe in the fridge?
I don't know, Amy. How do you put a giraffe in the fridge?
You open the door, put the giraffe in, and close the door. Oh, how do you put an elephant in the fridge?
You open the door, put the elephant in, and close the door.
Wrong. You open the door, take the giraffe out, put the elephant in, and close the door. All right. So lions, you know, they're like king of the jungle or whatever. So the big lion, yeah, they do. Very good. So the lion has a meeting for all the animals to come. Now all of them attend except for one. Which one is it?
Turtle, because he's slow.
No, the elephant, because he's in the fridge. Oh, yes. All right. So you come across, you're lost in the jungle, and you come across a river that has so many crocodiles. It's a crocodile-infested river. How do you get across?
Swim.
You swim across because the crocodiles are at the meeting that the lions held. Oh, yes. And I'm done because I'm just digging myself a hole here. Now to start the second half of the show, we have a couple of hams. Oh, yes, hams.
And hams. Ham.
But how are we?
Here's Jason, Amy, and Mike.
That's Mike.
It's a little different from what we've done before, so. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. I just remembered a joke. Okay, so why did the chicken cross the road?
Because he wanted to get the
Now why did the duck cross the road?
Chasing the chicken.
He was stuck to the chicken. Okay, so when I go like this, everybody, you know, we practice this every Sunday in church, right? Yeah. So when I go like this, we all laugh like Miles, okay? Yeah. Remember? Yeah, you don't know what I'm talking about. Okay, ready? Practice, ready? Yeah! Woo! Okay. So, up next is Bill Merrill again. Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
Music, you wonder where it all comes from, and I think this next song will let you know how I feel when music comes from.
Comedian, obviously.
Yeah.
Yeah. But people keep coming up to me with jokes, so I have one more for the night. Why don't lobsters share? Because they're shellfish. Oh, yeah, see? Right. Now, here's the other thing you didn't know, because first we traveled to the South Pacific, and now we are actually in Oklahoma. Now, we all know the story of Oklahoma. The boy meets the girl. The boy marries the girl. It's a territory that wants to be a state, but first, the farmer and the cowman must now be friends. So here's their version of the story.
Oh, what a beautiful morning! Oh, what a beautiful day! I got a beautiful feeling! Everything's going my way!
Oh, what a beautiful morning! Oh, what a beautiful day! I've got a beautiful feeling! Everything's going my way!
Hi, ma'am, how you doing?
I'm fine, sir, how are you?
Well, I'm doing real well. You know what? If we keep seeing each other like this, people are going to start to talk.
Don't lie.
tell you a little bit about it.
Okay. Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plain, and the waving wheat can sure smell sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oklahoma, every night my honey lamb and I sit alone and talk and watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand. And when we say,
dance like that, yeah. That's what I thought. All right. So, they're just gonna get situated in the back like they always do, you know. I don't know any more jokes. I'm not good at it. You know that. Oh, here's a cute one from little Sarah over there.
Hero.
Where do sheep go to get their hair cut? The barber shop. Oh, yes. Okay. So last but not certainly least, not certainly, I don't know if I said that right, Cheryl is going to sing us God Bless America.
The storm comes.
know everybody enjoyed it because it was fabulous. Wasn't it? Everybody that put this show on, they all did a tremendous job, and I'm thankful for them, and all the people who weren't on stage that helped in this show. Well, anyways, that's the end of the show. I appreciate everybody that came.
Can I just say something? I think Audrey.
Matthew was sitting here.
Can you hear me now? I just think Audrey deserves, she's the one who thought of this.